married in 1999, and we were married about 5 years, and we started trying to have kids and found out pretty quickly that we weren't able to. One day we met Ellie's birth mom. She chose us to be Ellie's adoptive parents. Evan was born on March 11th, 2013. We received a phone call probably a couple days later from our social worker telling us that there had been this baby born. He was 28 weeks.
When we met him, you know, we saw how, you know, fragile he was, and he didn't ask for any of this.
He also had some issues with his birth. Mom was positive for some drugs. Being a NICU nurse helped, and it did scare me because I do know, I see the babies that come into us that are addicted to drugs and the difficulties that they have and the difficulties that their parents have. And I also see the problems of a 28-weeker. You can have a 28-weeker that has an awesome course and, you know, has no problems. And then you can also have the 28-weeker that hits every roadblock possible.
Evan has bronchopulmonary dysplasia. That's BPD, and that's a complication small babies get when they're born too early and they have to be on the ventilator to keep them alive. It's a fairly common complication, and it's one that we fear because it makes it hard for them to breathe.
And there'd be times where, you know, he's not feeding as well as he should, or not taking, and so yeah, you have that go through your head, like, okay, what's gonna be next? Is there anything coming? Yeah, I really felt like the nurses, they care. And they would explain things, and they told me what was going on.
Most of the time that he was at Children's, he was working on getting off of his CPAP and his oxygen, and then once he was old enough, he was working on eating a bottle.
Him being born at 28 weeks, some people would consider would be bad, like, and it is bad. But at the same time, we see things differently. We feel like God actually removed him from a really bad situation in the mother's womb, because his mother, we don't know what else she was, you know, drugs, etc. So we feel that he was actually rescued from that environment and then pulled in and then brought into this environment. So in a way, we were thinking that this is good.
We were super excited for him to come home. Swing. His favorite thing right now is to try to walk. He loves to be outside. He'll cry when we come back inside. Loves to follow his sister around.
Woohoo!
Evan is, he's going on 14 months old, but because of his prematurity, since he was 3 months early, he's about 3 months behind. So he's acts more like a 11 month old.
So hey, so Erin, today we're going to be doing Evan's developmental assessment.
Today, Evan has an appointment at the BPD clinic.
So first, tell us, do you have any concerns that you want us to look at about his development today?
I know that they know what they're doing. They are watching every little thing that he does, and they work together with the nutrition people and with the doctors and the nurses and everything to make sure that he's growing and developing and doing everything, not just with occupational and physical therapy, but with his growth and his nutrition and everything.
Yes. One of the things that we've really come to terms with is the idea that these diseases don't stop when they're discharged from the NICU. In fact, a lot of the things that are really important to their long-term outcome occur after they're discharged. So this whole clinic was designed just for kids like Evan. So what today will be is a very comprehensive visit designed to make sure he's growing properly, designed to make sure that his development is moving forward, designed to make sure that if there are problems, they can be dealt with immediately rather than waiting.
Can you do it?
Our hopes for Evan, and we think that we have a very good chance, is that he'll do just fine and he'll be just like any other kid.
Good job.
It's amazing watching him grow and develop, and I mean, I'm excited to see what will happen in the future.
One, two, three. Woohoo!